Happy Halloween. Look behind you.
Hey guys, I'm Jennifer Perez from MysticNailsPR.com, and I'm going to show you how to make an acrylic nail and surround it with some sparkly glitter in different colors. So let's start off our spider with black acrylic. I'm going to use a number 8 Kolinsky acrylic brush. When you're doing a 3D design with acrylics, you can use a smaller brush, but since this brush has a small tip to it, it doesn't matter. You can use a number 8 and manage your acrylic, because you're not going to do very small detailed work on it. So just take a pearl of black and let it spread out. That way it will come out rounded. We're going to do 2 dots, one for the body and one for the head. Make sure you do make that bead smaller for the head area, and always wet your brush in the monomer correctly, and don't overload it. So this is what it'll look like behind it. I'm going to use a transparent tip, as you can see, and that way you can see the spider behind your nails. So let's make sure our brushes stay clean, load it with your monomer and then your black polymer, and let's start painting. It's kind of like painting, isn't it? Sculpting, because we are using acrylic. Let's just sculpt the legs. We're going to do 4 legs on each side. The legs that are on the top and the bottom are going to be slightly longer than the 2 in the middle. I'm going to speed this up in a bit, but just to make this video like shorter, because it is quite long right now. So this is the spider from behind. It's looking kind of nifty, isn't it? So you're going to do the same thing on the other side. Just make sure you do its front leg and the back leg longer than the 2 in the middle. Make sure you do wipe off your brush and use a paper towel to dry off any excess of monomer or acrylic that tends to stick on the brush sometimes. Just make sure you do keep it clean, and that way your brush stays intact. It won't get damaged. And remember always to clean it well after you are done. So if you need to flip the nail over, go ahead and do so. If you are working on a model or on your own hand with the nail on, just maneuver your hand and move around, shift around, get comfortable. And remember, practice makes perfect. So always practice on a nail tip before you manage to do this on a client. That way you do have the practice and the idea on how to go about this. Now, if you can tell, I did my little leg on the opposite side the wrong way. I just cleaned it up really fast before the acrylic sets and dries. And that way you can move it. So now moving on to our acrylic area, after you've finished the spider, just make sure you do let it set and dry up, and it won't peel off your acrylic tip right here, and the natural tip. So the acrylic I'm using right now is one I made myself. I mixed up transparent acrylic and mixed in some iridescent glitters to it. They have little greenish, bluish tones and yellowish tones. It depends where the sun hits and what little tones you can catch with your eye. So it does look marvelous, especially when you twist your hand around and you can you can see the glitter on the other side. So it is transparent, and maybe your spider legs will catch a glimpse or two of glitter, but doesn't matter. If you don't want your spider to be covered up in a way, just make sure you build your legs a little bit higher. Keep in mind, the thicker your black acrylic spider will be, the thicker your nail will be. So keep that in mind, ladies. So this is what it looks like from behind. It looks really nice. I'm really liking this design right here. So moving on to our green glitter. This is glitter used for skin, but you can embed it in your acrylic. You need to embed it. If you don't give it a coat of clear acrylic over it, it will just come right off your nail. So just go ahead and fill in the gaps wherever you want that limey green color. I love the two colors for Halloween, the lime green with the dark purple. That looks really nice, but I don't think I'm gonna add that much purple to this design right here. So I'm just gonna keep on adding my lime green glitter. And what I did was just took the glitter that I had left over on my piece of paper from the nail tips you see in the background. I will show you how to do that in the few upcoming days. Ladies, it does take time to edit, film, prepare your clips, etc., to be able to do a video and then upload it to YouTube. It takes quite a few time, and I'm always busy as a bee, so bear with me. So what I do is just add a tiny little bit of dark purple to the top. Now it's ready to be put on my nail. What I did was prepare your nail plate like you're supposed to, you know, with your antibacterial spray, your primer, your Bond-Aid. Remember always to file it well, etc. So after you glue on your tip, just apply those products you need for your acrylics not to lift. And this is a color that I mixed myself. It's kind of a flesh toned color. And apply the beads as you would sculpt a natural nail, a natural acrylic nail, that is. Just apply your bead and let it flow to the sides and push whatever you need to push to the sides, okay? So everything, after everything is set, file your nail, shape it, buff it, and I'm applying right now some peach scented cuticle oil. It smells so delish. Oh my god. You can buff your nail after you apply the oil also. It'll give you a nice sheen look. If you're not going to paint over it, just go ahead and give it a sheen shine. So after that, apply your favorite top coat. I'm using Beauty Secrets top coat. And this is what your nail looks like. And this is the side view. It's curved, as you can see. That's how I like my nails, nice and curved. And this is beneath. Looks pretty nifty, doesn't it? Let me know your thoughts. And if you have any suggestions, let me know at mysticnailspr.com or come on over to Facebook at mysticnails.fan. So take care and have a great day. Don't miss those 13 days of Halloween nail art. Go ahead and check out the playlist. I'll leave you the link on one of the pictures. See you later. Bye.